expect this type, because in school also you'll get a lot of questions on this type, and the type is e to the power x times f of x f dash x. So this type is basically useful with respect to school exams, and it comes directly from, and the derivation of the result of this directly comes from application of integration by parts. Okay. Now, what is the answer for this? First of all, let us understand the expression itself. We have some e to the power x. We have a function, and the derivative of the function is also added to it. Okay. However, in real problem that you'll be getting, you'll never get the term very explicit so that you identify, okay, this is the function, this is the derivative of the function. You may have those two terms linked or combined, and you need to segregate them out. Okay. So first let us find out what is the answer for this, and then we'll start taking up problems. Now, for finding the answer for this type of integrals, we first break this integral into two parts. One is e to the power x times f of x dx, and the other one is e to the power x plus f dash x dx. Now, do not disturb this expression. In this expression, take e to the power x as v and f of x as u. If you remember, I rate series e is always at the end. So there is no harm in taking e to the power x as v. There is no harm in taking e to the power x as v. The other function automatically becomes u. Apply integration by parts here, but do not disturb this term. If you apply integration by parts here, then u times integration of e to the power x is e to the power x minus integral of derivative of f of x, which is f dash x, into integral of e to the power x, which is e to the power x, whole integral. Okay. And as you would all realize by now that this term and this term are negative of each other, so they would cancel off. So you don't need to actually evaluate that. So ultimately leaving you with the answer e to the power x times f of x plus. Alright. So the moment you identify the function and the derivative is there in your problem along with e to the power x, this is the direct result you can use. Okay. To give you a simple example, if I ask you what is the integration of e to the power x log of secx plus tan x, what will you say? Which is the function? Yes, this is your function, right? This is your function. The derivative of log of secx is tan x, correct? So you can directly write without wasting much time that your answer will be e to the power x log of secx. Just a simple example. So let's take more examples based on this form. Very, very important form. Let me tell you, you're definitely going to get questions from this form in your school exams as well.
No, the moment you have a 2x, you cannot apply that. So first substitute 2x as t. Do you have school today?
Yeah.
Where is Jaju? First one is easy.
Yes. Second one is the 3 to the power 2x. We take this
take 2x as t first. Okay, first one. If you divide individually 1 and sin x cos x by cos square, you will be getting secant square x plus tan x, right? Now, it's very evident that the derivative of this term is this term. So your answer will be e to the power x tan x. Done. Over. This is the form, no? E to the power x, f of x, f dash x. So answer is e to the power x, f of x. Second one also done.
Sir, when you do integration by parts, is it wrong to take something which is not in the I label?
What?
For example, if you have to e power 2x into sec square x. Sec square x is like really often. So can I take sec square x is v and e power 2x? I can.
That makes sense. Okay. So the second one first, let's take 2x as t. So this implies 2dx is dt. So this implies dx is dt by 2. So entire problem converts to e to the power t 1 plus sin t by 1 plus cos t into dt by 2. So half will come. Now convert sin t as 2 sin t by 2, cos t by 2, and this as 2 cos square t by 2. Individually divide these two, so you will get half secant square x by 2 and tan x by 2, right? Now it's pretty obvious that I am writing x. That is pretty obvious that if I take this as my function, this will become the derivative of that function. So the answer will be e to the power t tan x by tan t by 2 into half plus.
So, I can use 1 plus cos square x and then take individually and then use the integration.
See, the problem is because of that, you should have strictly e to the power x over there. Because if your 2x is there, you may have to divide your answer by half. Here you can clearly say that if this is ft, this is f dash t. There's no doubt about it, right? So it meets the formula requirement, the condition e to the power t f of t f dash t. But here what will happen? It will be e to the power 2x f of x f dash x. Then it doesn't meet the formula exactly. It has to be exactly the formula, the form. So form, the form is e to the power x f dash x plus f of x.
So one question. So
yeah.
Did you forget e to the power x?
Sorry?
Is there no e to the power x?
No, there is no e to the power x in the third one. That is the problem actually. So first two is understood, no? No doubt regarding first two. Vishak?
So
till there you are correct. After that, one small manipulation you have to do. Hint is small manipulation you have to do. Okay.
Sir, I got it. Sir, is it into the party, lock in the single party?
Okay, correct. So first thing, log x as t. Okay, Nishan. So x is e to the power t. Okay. So dx is also e to the power t dt. So can I say this integral converts as log of t plus 1 by t square, and dx will become e to the power t dt. So till this step most of you have got. Now the problem arising here is that log t and 1 by t square are not related to each other as being derivatives of one another, right? Right, nowhere near to it. So what I will do here, given that I am manipulative, I can add 1 by t, subtract 1 by t. Right. Coincidentally, 1 by t is the derivative of this, and this is the derivative of this. Correct? Are you getting it?
Yeah.
So, did you ever imagine that log t and 1 by t square were both related to?
1 by t.
So, basically, you can break it up as two problems. One is this. And other is this. Okay. So here this is your f of t, f dash t. F of t, f dash t. So your answer finally will be e to the power t log t. Put your t back. So this is your answer. Log t minus e to the power t by t plus c. Put your t back. T was log x. So e to the power t is x. Log t will be log of log x. Minus e to the power t is again x. By t is log x. Fourth one is pretty easy. Try it out. E to the power x by? Absolutely correct. Very good. Chalo, we'll discuss the fourth one. Alright, so fourth one. If you square up the numerator, you get 1 plus x square minus 2x. Correct? Now just group these two terms and individually divide them by 1 plus x square whole square. If you take this as your function, then your derivative of this function would be minus 2x by 1 plus x square whole square, correct? So this is the function, this is the derivative of the function. You can call it like this. This is the derivative of the function. Okay, and this is your function. So your answer is going to be e to the power x f of x.